Hello for Thursday, September 9th, and the markets on Wednesday weren't really that interesting. We had a couple stocks that moved, one that gapped, one that moved up pretty nicely, but then it gave up a lot of its gains later in the day. So if you're trading those, just trading ones that have been up at one or two days already in advance, just watch it when you have nice profits and start taking some. We may be in a bullish trend still in the moment, but we're not going up at this day anyway, although the markets did close up. Here's the Dow, 15-minute chart. You can see 40, what was it? We closed up about 46 points, but the chart doesn't show so great. So we talked about this first trend line, the second trend line we added today, but this first line here, it was in the channel and come down, then it broke through. The day it came down to this point, that's when we threw the other parallel line up here. It moved above it for a while and then came down below it, and the moving average is also falling right back to this line. So it's still strong enough that it's maintaining those lines. Now, of course, a break below there will probably test it to at least the low of the day. That would be then tomorrow. I'll see how it goes, but that'd be in the area to watch this. And then, of course, you can have a line coming up from the top here, a trend. That would be on the upside, but at the moment we see nothing on the MACD to indicate we don't have any positive divergence. If that starts turning up while this is coming down, that points to a probable change in direction going back up. At the moment, everything's still going down, so we can't tell you there's going to be an upside. Now, and as far as the SPX, this is the same 60-minute chart as yesterday. This one also, once it broke down through here, we just took one of the lines and brought a parallel channel over to the base of this. And that is where it stopped, ended the day right on there. As you can see where we closed yesterday, we closed right at this 21-day moving average. This is the red moving average here. And if it crosses the blue average, that would be a sell sign. That would be just if you're using this as a guide for kind of mechanical trades. As you can see, it's done pretty well. It got you to short up at this area and then go long, then go short again, go long, go short. This was a little whipsaw, not much profit there, but a few points, and then go long here. So that's worked out okay. Still, like the others, it has no positive divergence yet. Doesn't give a clue to what's going on, but you can see where the points are as far as what might indicate going down or up in Russell 2000. Likewise, it's just in this little range until it breaks back over the 643.73 area or below the 50-day EMA. It's just in a tight range. That's all, as would be the Russell 1000 and so forth. And the FAS is not interesting. We showed that. We just had it up as well. Now, gold did reach a high. Probably was the all-time high, 123.50. Someone pointed out, you know, that's website, 123 gold. Well, GLD hit 123. So, and you can see it's got kind of an indecisive candle. Maybe even a little spinning top, a little not a great candle, could be signaling a pullback. Look, the GLD didn't have great volume, making this little new high didn't draw in people. Maybe if it really breaks out, but I wouldn't mind to see a pretty good pullback in it, and it will come at some point, but we may go up from here. We're not terribly overbought on anything, but you can see there's negative divergence here on the stochastics. We had a high here when gold was much lower, and it's going down. We don't have anything negative as far as the MACD is okay, but histogram as well, negative divergence suggesting a pullback. But of course, that could change in a couple days going up as well, and GDX has not really changed. There wasn't enough movement. Now, silver, it did reach this high here and pull back, and we're going to do a separate video on silver. It won't be on the site. We'll put a Twitter. We'll tweet it so you can get, if you're subscribed, you know, just go to twitter.com/stocktiger and then click on the follow. Once you have a Twitter account, then you'll get all the tweets. Okay, additions to the watch list. ROVI. This was mentioned in the chat room. I asked who mentioned it, and I didn't get a good response. So thanks anyway. They pointed this one out. It looked at a good volume. Now, it, like many stocks, came down and lost the gains of the day. But I think if it can get back over that 44.95, or maybe even this height here, I think in the on the watch list we put it at that level. But if you're an experienced trader, probably over the same little level in here, about 44.50-ish. Might be a good look in your 60-minute chart, I would recommend. But look at very nice volume. See, it's had good volume in the past and pulled back. That's why it's not a sure thing. If we're in a bull market and you see this kind of, or you just can enter and put a stop down here. But in this market, things can not, it's quite the same. Anyway, it still looks good to go. And to watch that. Now, CMTL, you know, we like these long candles on the left. We like them when they're a little bit farther out, like if it were back in June. But still, this could work. The problem is it gapped up. If it gaps up again, it could be bought, but be really careful. So it needs to go sideways for a while. But what we liked is a big, strong volume for this stock, 1.8 million shares, much higher than what its average is in here. So a pullback or going sideways for a while would be okay. Otherwise, if it breaks back over this 22.95, I guess this is really a 22.95, so $23. And look, 23.57 is the 50-day up just over here. But if it can go sideways and then break out over that, a lot of times these candles don't have that much resistance, because anyone who got caught in that single day is hoping that it's going to go up, so they don't want to sell, they want to hang on. Anyway, it could have a couple buck gain. We'll see how it goes, but that's what we're putting on the watch list. It might never break out to begin with. Okay, IGTE has this little triangle going for it. It broke out also, and like so many other stocks, it gave back its gains. But if it moves back up over this, maybe the 1704 that's just to the left, that might be a decent trade. 1743 would be the next area. The top, the high of the day for Wednesday, but I think probably the 1704 might be the way to trade it. Especially if it doesn't happen first thing. When the things happen in the first 15 minutes of the day, shy away from them as a rule, because they'll a lot of times pull back. But it had good volume as well, so this one will add to the watch list. PMC Sierra. If techs get a boost, it has a nice pattern. The problem in this little pattern here, the rest of the pattern is pretty bad, with a gap down on high volume, then a second gap down as well on high volume. Even higher, that was. But it's been moving back up, and then it had a gap back up. So it's right at the 50-day. It's going to try and get over that. It might have to drop back some more first. But anyway, it's on the watch list on a move over the 50-day. It's good for a play, at least, for a day. And we'll see how it goes in that day and take some profits. That was the first day. Anyway, LNT, this is just your normal breakout, but also higher volume was on Wednesday. We like that and everything. And so if it can move back over this 36.30, that looks like 36.33 actually got for the high of the day. So above that with good volume. That's a possibility, as is PHK. And I like this chart. I just like the, you know, I like clean charts. Meaning, now this one sometimes moves just a little bitty bit, little tiny bit. It's not a high volume stock, but 500,000 shares was okay, and usually it does less than that, but this is the average in here, and it's been pretty consistent. So it's not a big trader as far as the big percentage moves, but it's sometimes can be consistent. But I like the looks of the setup here, and I think over 1325, you know, on improving volume, that would be good as well. 1350 is the next level, 1360 is the next level, but 1325, a lot of people may be looking for the sideways or up to this level. That's why that 25 cents between here and there might be doable, because people are looking right away for at least to move up that 25 cents, and enough people think that way and it will happen. OCLR, we talked, I think the day before yesterday or the day before, whenever, Tuesday, we talked about the about a flagpole or about a flag in general. We said, well, you really need a pole. Now, here's what we have, a pole. Here, a straight up nice pole. We got a little 2-day flag. Now, of course, it may break down, but the volume was good on the pole, and it's less on the pullback here. But if it does break back out of that, that's a good sign. So we'll watch for this to break out and then to get over this 1329. That'd put it back over the trend line as well. And that may set up for some bigger gains if we do indeed have a couple weeks left of possible rally. STXS is another one. This is a not such a great setup, but it had good volume. And the point is that very good volume going up, low volume this whole time coming down, then bigger volume. They want to get it back above here. They might not be successful, but it could be a momentum trade from this point up to this $4, which is the 200-day EMA. So, you know, that's not a big move there, but if it gets there, maybe eventually we'll try this 450, which is, you know, a decent gain. So anyway, if you like this kind of trade and this price range, STXS, we've added that as well, TMRKO. I haven't put that on the watch list, I don't think. I'm watching that. I'm showing it here because I forgot to move it, but you can see it looks to me it's a little too extended. I think it needs a day or two, and we'll look at it again. We'll put it on the watch list if it if it stays in this line and doesn't break out. Maybe if we didn't mention it, it would break out or whatever. Fred's store. Fred's, you know, this had broken out. It was a very good move on the one-day move up. And then the next day it moves a little bit. And when it loses that day's low, it's, you know, it's time to get out. So I think you've taken your profits on this one, because it didn't continue, and then it broke after the first day's little low right in here. Anyway, it's now come back to the moving averages. Look at this volume, much less volume here. So look for a bounce. We like 3 or 4 day pullbacks, and this is the third day on Wednesday. So Thursday's the fourth day. So look for a bounce on Thursday. If it doesn't get much lower than this line, a little bit's okay. We'll give it a little slack, but if it looks low, if then it starts moving up, that could be a buy with a stop just underneath, because it may try and test that again. In the past, it hasn't always done that, but this one is right by the moving averages, and that may work out. I think that's all of the watch list. This one may come, SMG, in the future. Now let's look what else we have here. Just a couple that are on the watch list that pulled back one day and then moved up. So this pulled back on Tuesday and back up on Wednesday. CWTR is close to the possible buy around this 493. And then it's 508 is the 50-day EMA. And the last one is also on the watch list. That's HTCH. And this had pulled back as well. And then on Wednesday started moving back up. So we're looking over about this 350 area. So those are the new ideas for today, for Thursday. Hope you have a great day trading. Come in and say hi in the chat room. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.